take some lean ground beef. And this is better for you because it's extra lean. Beef is nice and brown, but we've got to get rid of some of that grease. I use the extra lean because it's healthier, but this is a way to get rid of your grease. Oh. Did you know that all you have to do is just add a paper towel right into the pan, and that is going to soak up the grease. Now we're going to add some garlic. I'm just using the jarred garlic because I feel like that's even quicker and easier, and that is what we like here. But would you prefer to use fresh? Let me know what you think. Now we're going to add some onion. I'm actually using frozen chopped onion. I have solved the problem of tears with onions, and this is it, y'all. Next, we're going to add some Italian seasoning. There we go. And we're going to just mix that up. I've moved my heat to low now, and this is going to be ready to put in our pot. We're going to take a big jar that's 45 ounces of your favorite pasta sauce. Pour that right into the bottom of your pot. You could use two of the small standard size jars. What's your favorite brand of pasta sauce? Let me know what you think. Now we're gonna take that meat, that ground beef, and that's gonna go right on top. We've got some garlic and onions and seasoning in there. There we go. Top that with a little bit of fresh ground pepper and some of our salt. This is that Himalayan pink salt. They say it's better for you. What do y'all think? Is that just hearsay or is there some truth to that? Now you're gonna mix all of this up. Mix up your ground beef, your onions, your garlic with your sauce. Now, I'm showing y'all a quick and easy version, but you can modify this recipe. If you wanna make your sauce from scratch, you can. In fact, you can make your spaghetti from scratch, but I'm not gonna do that here today because I want this to be easy. Now I'm gonna add our spaghetti. This is already pre-cooked. And I cooked it about 75%, so it's not completely done because it will continue to cook in the pot just a little bit. Now I've got a 4-quart pot, so I probably could have gone with a little bit less spaghetti.
That looks like a lot of spaghetti.
Maybe I should have added less. What kind of...
Here, I'll help. I'll get some of that.
Thank you for the help. All right, but that's okay. We're just gonna push it down in there. And we're gonna mix it up. You're gonna cover our spaghetti with the meat sauce.
It smells so good right now.
This is gonna be yummy.
Spaghetti in a crock pot, just like the Italians do it.
Now listen, don't you make the Italians come for me.
I'm an Italian.
So. I know, he's Italian. He can make that joke. Okay, now we're gonna take some cream cheese. We're gonna take about a half cup of cream cheese. I'm an eyeballer. Y'all like me and you just like to eyeball it, or do you need exact measurements? That looks about a half cup, right?
Sure.
We also need some ricotta. There's some in the fridge. Would you grab that, please?
I can get it for you. Here we go. Ricotta. Excuse me. Here.
Now, the name of this recipe, thank you very much, is called Million Dollar Spaghetti because we are giving spaghetti an upgrade. Now, we're going to add some ricotta.
I didn't think spaghetti could get any better.
Oh, yeah. You just wait. We're going to add the ricotta.
Right.
To our cream cheese. And now we're gonna just try to mix this up. And it's okay if the cream cheese is a little bit clumpy. I did leave it out so that it would soften a bit. But we're just gonna get a mixture of the two cheeses in little clumps, and we're gonna mix that in with our spaghetti.
Hey, Misty.
Hang on.
You don't have to do anything. You don't have to say
anything. Just trust me.
All right.
All right, so we've got it all mixed up in there nicely, and this is gonna go on top of our spaghetti.
Hey, Misty. Did you hear about the spaghetti noodle that got into a car accident?
No, what happened?
The paramedics tried to save him, but in the end, he passed away.
Oh my God. You and your jokes. We're gonna just dump this on top in little dollops, and then we're gonna mix it in. See, we've got a nice creamy spaghetti that's gonna knock your socks off.
Exciting.
And now we're just gonna kind of blend that up. You just want your ricotta and cream cheese. Whoa, look at how good that looks. Well, we're gonna mix it up so that everything is combined. We need that cream cheese and ricotta on top of all of our pasta. It's looking good already.
Yeah. 4, 3, 2.
And the last step is we're gonna top that with some mozzarella. Now, do y'all like to have the bagged cheese because it's easier, or do you like to shred your own? Let me know in the comments what you think about that. We're gonna cover this, and I think we're only gonna cook this on low for maybe a couple hours. You only need to cook it long enough to kind of heat it up and melt that cheese because we don't want the pasta to overcook, but it's gonna be yummy, and we're gonna taste test before you know it. First, I've got a riddle though. what begins with a T, ends with a T, and has T in it. So let us know your guesses. What begins with a T, ends with a T, and has T in it. We'll see what you think. All right, y'all, our $1 million spaghetti is ready. Ooh, I rhymed. Inside of this pot, we've got our ground beef with onions and garlic and our tomato sauce. And then we have lots of different cheeses. We ended up adding ricotta and cream cheese mixed in with all the pasta and the meat. And then we topped that with mozzarella. And of course, there was some Italian seasoning too. But the main part of this is the spaghetti. In fact, Kyle, will you come show them your spaghetti trick?
Oh yeah, okay.
Y'all gotta see
you
this.
Guys, all right.
If you didn't know, we are also magicians. I am not a chef. I'm an entertainer learning and enjoying cooking, but this is gonna be the thing you're talking about tomorrow.
All right, so here's the spaghetti trick. So you take one spaghetti noodle here and eat it.
Are you really eating that?
Okay.
This is crazy.
Okay, now, I try to get back. And that's it. That's the spaghetti trick right there.
That is crazy. Right. That was so much fun. I'm ready to taste test our pasta though. So we've got nice and melty cheese. I'm just gonna dig in. I have another question for y'all too. Is it okay to break spaghetti? I've got some heated debates going on our page about this, and I want to know if it's okay to break spaghetti. Look at that.
That is a lot. There
you go. That looks incredible. All of the good things mixed together in this delicious dish. So we've got our cream cheese and ricotta. Wow. And you know what? That pasta looks like it's perfectly cooked too. We didn't overcook it. And all you have to do is just make sure you don't overcook it when it's in the pot, and then it should be fine if you're just cooking it on low in the crock pot. You gotta get it here.
All right, I'm coming in for this taste test here.
It's a lot of cheese. Surely y'all aren't gonna tell me I was too stingy with the cheese this time. You want the first bite?
No, you can have the first bite.
Okay, I'm gonna go.
All right.
Mm-hmm.
Is it good? All right, here we go.
I'll let you get it just so I don't make a mess. Man, it's good, isn't it?
You know what? It actually tastes a little bit like spaghetti lasagna. Maybe it's the ricotta cheese that I
Yeah, that's a good combination. So y'all let me know what you think of this one. Let me know if you like seeing the magic and if you want to see more of that in our future videos. One more bite.
Sure.
Y'all, this is so good. Mm.